So in green hydrogen, we have a really neat solution to enable the energy transition. We talk about the global south effectively supplying the global north. And what is so distinctly different from how the oil and gas and the mining industry have worked is that you cannot export the wind or the sun. It has to be developed in country, and it is renewable in nature. We're looking at producing millions of tons of green hydrogen annually that is produced with Namibian labor, Namibian materials, equipment, services, etc., etc. So the geopolitical landscape and the geo-economic landscape is shifting.
It's economic development through green industrialization.
My name is Toni Beukes, and I am the head of ESG for the Hyphen Project. So Hyphen is a fully integrated gigawatt scale project. It is located in Namibia. The Hyphen Project will be located in the first green hydrogen valley. Clean hydrogen is essentially hydrogen that is produced through the process of electrolysis, so where we use water to extract the hydrogen, and it's powered by renewable energies. What makes Namibia a really competitive player in this new emerging sector is its incredible wind and solar resources. Above that, that wind and solar resource is co-located, and that is not necessarily always the case, which means you don't have to build additional infrastructure to connect those two sources of energy, and you are then able to deliver a lower cost of that production. The pivotal role that green hydrogen can play in the mosaic of the energy transition is really to target what we refer to as the hard to abate sectors, such as, you know, heavy industry, shipping, aviation. And the beauty of green hydrogen is that it's able to produce solutions to cater for the decarbonization of those sectors. You can take green hydrogen, add different elements to then produce various synthetic fuels to cater for the sector, including aviation. And that's the mega contribution that green hydrogen can make to the transition. What motivates me in the work that we do at Hyphen is very much the potential transformative capacity of a project like this for the economy. So countries in the global south, like Namibia, can now become the alternative supply sources for countries in the global north. And those countries, incidentally, do not have those resources to do it domestically. Namibia has developed a green hydrogen industrialization strategy and roadmap. That infrastructure will allow Namibia to supply green electrons into the Southern African power pool, and in turn, enable countries like South Africa to decarbonize. My call for action would be premised on one key word, and that is collaborate, collaborate, collaborate. First, it's in the investment space. The International Energy Agency estimates that currently there's about $1 billion investment going into hydrogen annually. That needs to be ramped up significantly to about 150 billion by 2030, so that we can rapidly scale up its production and in the cost of the technology. And the second one is the need for skills development and collaboration at really a global level. Skills development has historically been left out of the equation when we talk about the energy transition. I think it's incredibly important for us to educate the youth about this new industry. Sorry, that's making me a little emotional. Give me a second. I'm very expressive with my tears. It's not a Hyphen problem alone. It's not a Namibia problem. It's really a global problem. Namibia has 67,000 unemployed graduates. These are people that have been trained but have never had the opportunity, because of the size of the economy, to really work in the area. And so how do we bring in technology and expertise to enable that upskilling to really be able to utilize Namibians for a project like Hyphen? When we consider the pathways for the scaling of green hydrogen globally, when we talk about what does it mean to develop the green hydrogen project sustainably, we may need to look at new ways and new policies in this regard, environmental protection, that is. Namibia also is one of the countries, only countries in the world that has environmental protection included in its constitution, and its total, something like 42% of its total land area is under one or other form of environmental protection. The world needs about 9,000 projects the size of Hyphen to get to the 2050 net zero target. So if you can imagine the land that is required to house 9,000 projects the size of Hyphen, the idea of environmental sustainable development, social sustainable development of green hydrogen projects is an area that is slightly unexplored. And that for me is a very, very clear pathway of how we can globally scale up the production of green hydrogen for the transition. Namibia has the benefit of being one of the first countries globally to define that what that is.
If the tech, the finance, and everything else is in place to enable projects like Hyphen, the real breakthrough will be reaching some kind of tipping point where countries like Namibia is able, first of all, to really be able to scale up or utilize, fully utilize its capacity for scalability of green hydrogen. And that is really significant. And then again, positioning Namibia as a key player in the green hydrogen global market.
My hope for Hyphen's future, my hope for Namibia's future is that we get these projects implemented. We get them implemented so that Namibia can realize its full potential. And so that projects like these can contribute to Namibia achieving its national development goals and in turn its Vision 2030, that ultimately helps us deliver on our SDGs. So that's my hope for the future, that this is a pathway to not just a better Namibia, but a better world. Thank you.